Photoshop versus Illustrator. It's a common doubt to wonder whether you should use one or the other, especially since both softwares have very similar interfaces and can even be used to create the same things in some cases. But knowing which one suits best your needs can save you time and lots of headaches. So, which one should you be using? What can you do with each one? Well, the short answer is, if you're a designer, you use Illustrator, and if you're a photographer, you use Photoshop. Illustrator is traditionally used to create logos, icons, infographics, ads, and all sorts of printed media. On the other hand, Photoshop, as the name itself implies, shines when it's used to edit photography, because it allows you to adjust exposure, contrast, change colors and lighting, and composite several images together. These differences between both softwares are explained primarily by how each software generates images. This is the core difference between them. Illustrator uses vectors, while Photoshop uses bitmap images. Okay, but what are vectors and bitmaps, I hear you asking? Well, let's start with bitmaps, because you're probably already used to them. Bitmaps, also known as raster images, are image files made out of pixels, which are, literally, bits mapped on a grid, hence the name bitmap. Files like BMPs, PNGs, or JPEGs. BMPs were the original bitmap files, but they were huge in size, so other files came along, such as PNGs and JPEGs, which added compression to the images, giving you smaller file sizes in exchange for a small quality loss. But at the end of the day, they are all images made out of pixels. They have a set number of vertical and horizontal pixels, which we call resolution. And the main downside of a bitmap file is their fixed resolution. Since a bitmap file is made out of a finite number of pixels, if you try to increase its size, you will lose quality. Your computer will try to create new pixels to fill the space as best as it can, but it won't be perfect. If you scale up too much, you will notice the quality loss. Vector files, on the other hand, don't have this problem. They store the image data as points in space using mathematical formulas. You might remember studying vectors in high school math. This data is then read and rendered by your computer and displayed to you as an image. I know, it's kinda hard to understand like that, but hang on. The most common vector files are SVGs and EPSs, but there are also software-dependent files like AI files for Illustrator or CDR files for CorelDRAW. PDFs are kind of a jack of all trades, because they are very good at storing both bitmaps and vectors. The fact that vector files store data as mathematical points in space instead of pixels means they don't have a fixed resolution. You can scale vectors to infinity and they will never lose quality. The image will never get pixelated. And this is great when you're working with logos, business cards, and other printed media. If you're new to this world, vector files might seem strange, but you actually see them all the time. Virtually every font file is based on vectors. If you zoom on a website, for example, the text will never lose quality. Your browser will just continually render bigger and bigger characters, because they are not made out of pixels. But vectors have their limitations as well. Virtually any image can be converted to a bitmap and stay visually the same, but not any image can be turned into a vector. Vectors are not very good at being realistic, so things like photos and realistic drawings are nearly impossible to be turned into vectors without noticeable visual changes. Vectors really shine with illustrations, icons, and symbols, because there's nothing a vector does best than solid geometric shapes. All these differences don't necessarily make one type of image, or even one application, better than the other. They're just different softwares for different uses. Now, let's explore each one a little bit further. Photoshop is king when dealing with photography. Since it's impossible for a camera to save a photo as a vector image, there's little you can do with it in Illustrator. Photoshop, on the other hand, is the best friend of photographers. Starting with the fact that Photoshop can open RAW files, which are special uncompressed image files that most professional cameras can create. They're commonly referred to as digital negatives because they offer great flexibility in editing colors and lighting. In Photoshop, you have a wide array of adjustments that are simple and easy to use, making it easy to change things like exposure, contrast, and saturation. You can change the intensity of shadows and highlights, change one specific color, and even increase the sharpness of the image. Photoshop also comes with Camera Raw, which is sort of an inbuilt plugin, where you have a huge selection of adjustments to make, from changing the temperature of the photo, all the way to messing with curves, individual colors, performing color grading in different areas of the image, such as shadows, midtones, and highlights, and even applying filters or removing lens distortion. All these adjustments can be stacked on top of each other and easily turned on and off. You can also create masks on these adjustments so that they only affect a specific portion of the image. Photoshop is also very good at compositing images. In Photoshop, it's very easy to create complex masks to hide specific parts of a layer, which would be nearly impossible to do in Illustrator. You can then stack one image on top of the other and create whatever your imagination allows you to. Still on the topic of photography, Photoshop also counts with a diverse selection of tools for restoration. Whether someone has a pimple on their face or an unwanted bird appeared in the sky, Photoshop gets you covered. You can either use one of the restoration tools like the stamp, healing brush, or patch tool, or make a selection and let Photoshop's AI fill the selected area with its content-aware fill. Since a few versions ago, Photoshop also counts with neural filters powered by AI, which allows you to completely change images, applying artistic styles, colorizing black and white photos, softening skin, or restoring old scanned images, all with just a few clicks. All that being said, it's clear that Photoshop is a tool developed with photography and photographers in mind. Now, let's jump to design and take a look at Illustrator. As we mentioned before, vectors shine with geometric shapes, which, in fact, are also one of the bases of graphic design. And while you can also work with geometric shapes in Photoshop, Illustrator has a wide array of tools to easily manipulate and create all sorts of complex shapes. Not to mention, it has way better performance at these tasks. You have the basic shape tools to create rectangles, ellipses, and polygons, but you also have tools like the Pathfinder and the Shape Builder, which allows you to combine shapes in complex ways to create your own unique designs. And when we talk about vectors, it's also important to understand how they work and how easy it is to manipulate them. At their core, vectors are made up of three elements: anchors, paths, and handles. Anchors are the points in space we mentioned before, paths are the lines that connect these points, and handles control the direction and curvature of a curved path. And by using tools like the Direct Selection tool, the Pen tool, or the Curvature tool, you can easily create and manipulate these three elements to transform the shapes as you see fit. Moving on, two other fundamental aspects of graphic design are text and color, and they're both super easy to work with in Illustrator. Text, not only because of the better performance it has over Photoshop, since fonts are usually vector-based, but also because of the vast amount of options to customize your characters and paragraphs. And color, due to the great amount of possibilities to create and organize color palettes, with panels such as the color panel, the color guide, swatches, and libraries. With its artboard system, Illustrator is perfect for creating multi-page documents such as catalogs, folders, and presentations. And talking about presentations, Illustrator also has an array of graph tools that allow you to input your data and make beautiful graphs and charts with just a few clicks. Combine that with previously mentioned shapes, text, and color capabilities, and you have a full-fledged tool for graphic design. I hope this video shed some light on your doubts. One tool is not better than the other, they're just different softwares with different uses. If you enjoyed this video, check this other one that is on the screen right now. Don't forget to like and subscribe and post your doubts in the comment section for me to answer. Thank you so much for watching and have a great day. Bye!